students, we are at page number 78 NCERT and we are doing chapter number 4 psychological disorders. In this video I am going to cover dissociative disorders and I have already note down for you all the further types of dissociative disorders which we are going to cover one by one. Alright, so let's begin. So we are at page number 78. Now first we have to understand what is dissociative disorder. We've already done with somatoform disorder in the previous video. Dissociative can be viewed as severance of the connection between ideas and emotions. Dissociation ho gayi na, ideas emotions mein kya ho gaya? Association, disturb hone ko dissociative kehte hain. So dissociation involves feeling of unreality, things which are not real, ek to ye aa gaya. Entrenchment, depersonalization, we will cover that. And sometimes loss or shift of identity. Matlab main kaun hu, meri identity maine lose kar di ya maine kisi dusre par switch kar di. Right? Then sudden temporary alterations. Ye aap dekhenge apne notes mein. Temporary alterations of consciousness that blot out painful experience are a defining characteristic of dissociative. क्या किया हमने? हमने अपने behavior को alter कर लिया consciousness में, मतलब जागते हुए, समझते हुए मैंने मैं ना बनकर अपनी identity छोड़कर किसी और को adopt करके और मैंने उसको बात करना शुरू कर दिया. Let me tell you an example. In my area, there's a person who is suffering from this disorder, which I could recognize because I've never talked to him because he's always on the roads and speaking something and talking. His age is close to 50, 55. That means 50, 55 ke hai to independence ki ladai to nahi dekhi hogi 47. But whenever I listen to him or pay attention, what he speaks is as if he is a freedom fighter. And he speaks that हमने अंग्रेजों को भगा दिया, मैंने इस तरह से लड़ाई की. मतलब अगर आप उनकी बात सुने तो लगेगा कि yes वो क्या है, कोई freedom fighter रहे हैं. But his age is not that. So his birth is maybe after 50, 55. So but क्योंकि उन्होंने अपनी identity को shift कर दिया किसी दूसरी identity पर and he enacts like that. Maybe he must have read about him somewhere or अपने कॉन्शियसनेस में उन्होंने उनके बारे में सुना होगा, वो पर्सनालिटी उनके माइंड में बैठी और उसी को ही उन्होंने अलर्ट करना शुरू कर दिया. डिड यू गेट द पॉइंट? आई एम श्योर थोड़ा सा आइडिया हो गया. ठीक है, आगे चले. फोर कंडीशंस आर इंक्लूडेड इन दिस. कौन कौन सी? डिसोसिएटिव एमनीजिया, डिसोसिएटिव फ्यू, एंड देन यू हैव डिसोसिएटिव आइडेंटिटी डिसऑर्डर, डीपर्सनलाइजेशन. सो वी विल कवर ऑल सेलिएंट फीचर्स ऑफ सोमेटोफॉर्म एंड डिसोसिएटिव. The difference is given in the box below so that you can cover later once we will through with the dissociative disorder. The very first which you are supposed to write down in your notes by making the first heading is dissociative amnesia. It is characterized by extensive but selective memory loss. Extensive yani bilkul yaad nahi aana, lekin selective memory loss that has no known organic cause. कोई हेड इंजरी हुई हो तो समझ में आता है, चलो जी बात कोई भूल गए या उस कंपोनेंट को हर्ट हो गया. मतलब ब्रेन में भी तो हमारे सेगमेंट्स है ना, उस पर्टिकुलर सेगमेंट में कुछ चोट लग गई और वो भूल गए. लेकिन यहाँ देर इज नो ऑर्गेनिक रीजन फॉर दैट, देर इज नो हेड इंजरी, बट दैट पर्टिकुलर लाइफ के वो इवेंट्स नहीं आ. सो इट इज द सिलेक्टिव मेमोरी लॉस. अंडरलाइन कर लीजिए, याद रहेगा, ईजी करना रहेगा याद रहना. सम पीपल के नॉट रिमेंबर एनीथिंग अबाउट देयर पास्ट, कुछ भी याद नहीं पुराना. Others can no longer recall specific events. हमारे साथ भी होता है बहुत बार, हमें याद नहीं आता यार उसकी मैरिज कौन से ईयर हुई थी, कौन सा मंथ था, क्या पहना था, मतलब कुछ चीजें हम भी नहीं रिकॉल कर पाते. People, places, objects, while their memory for other events remains intact. मतलब I remember what am I teaching, I remember everything, I know the ways, I know everything, but I'm unable to recall a specific event. Okay? So this disorder often associated with an overwhelming stress. जब बहुत ज़्यादा stress हो तो हम कभी कभी वो event को recall नहीं कर पाते, लेकिन ये extensive नहीं है. With the passage of time थोड़ी सी grilling करके हम पहुंच जाते हैं वहां तक, लेकिन यहाँ पर क्या है, there is a memory loss which is involved. Alright? Dissociative fugue is what? It is essential feature, its essential feature is an unexpected travel away from home and workplace, okay, the assumption of a new identity, आपने अपने आप को imagine किया सारी जिंदगी इंडिया में रहे, सोच रहे दुबई में है और मैं ना वो शेख था, इस तरह से कोई नया assumption of new identity या मुझे जानता था, मैं उससे मिला, कभी गए भी नहीं, and the inability to recall the previous identity, okay, अब वही बन गए और यस उसी को ही सोचने लगे उसी के बारे में और previous identities को भूल गए. The fugue usually ends when the person suddenly wakes up with no memory of the events that occurred during the fugue. अब ये जो fugue में हो गया, मतलब आपने खुद ही बनाया और ये end हो जाती है. कैसे? जब आप उससे जाग गए, आप उस fugue से, उस धुंधलाहट जो आपने बना रखी थी अपने mind में, उससे जब आप बाहर आ जाते हैं, तो आप इस disorder से वापस आ जाते हैं. या जो भी the one who is suffering. Dissociative identity disorder क्या है? Often refer to a multiple personality. ये आपने बहुत बार movies में भी देखा है, split personality भी क्या देते हैं. Multiple personalities means एक ही बंदा एक से ज़्यादा ज़िंदगियों को जीने लगता है. या वो बन जाता है जिसके बारे में इधर बहुत ज़्यादा पढ़ता है. So हिंदी movies में भी we've seen, even in Bollywood all type movies we've seen that. So it is often associated with the traumatic experience in childhood. You must remember this Vidya Balan's movie where Akshay Kumar was there. I don't remember the movie's name, but you remember that this girl Vidya Balan used to live with her grandmother, or parents shayad nahi the, aur wo stories sun ke apne aap ko wahi imagine karna shuru kar deti thi. I'm unable to recall the name of the movie, so you must have recalled it by now. Okay, experience kiya tha koi traumatic experience in childhood, zyadatar un logon ke sath aise hota hai. In this disorder, the person assumes alternate personalities that may or may not be aware of each other. There's a book on this person, again I am unable to call, usne 26 personalities ji. Matlab, split mein bhi kuch ke mind mein do personalities aa sakti hai, teen. There was a person, Bob, and he lived 26 different personalities in his life, okay? He is in American jail, I suppose, and he wrote this book, and you can refer that book. It's a very good book. Depersonalization mein kya hoga? It involves a dream-like state in which the person has a sense of being separated both from self and from reality. In depersonalization, there's a change of self-perception. Apne baare mein aap apni perception change karke, and the person's sense of reality is temporarily lost or changed. Matlab kya hua? It's a dream-like situation. Aap apne dream mein chale gaye aur apne aap ko bhul gaye. And you're living that life and suddenly you've come back. So it's called depersonalization se thoda alag ho gaye. So these all are the parts of dissociative disorders. When it comes to making a difference between somatoform disorder and dissociative, you must learn. It's very, very important. It's given on page number 78. In box 4.1. So what how have you compared is, ek taraf hypochondriasis ko rakh diya, dusri taraf dissociative amnesia ko rakh diya. Hypochondriasis bhi humne padha hai, isme kya tha? Medical evaluation, insignificant symptoms hote hain serious illness ke, usko aapne amnesia se compare kar diya, ye traumatic event, stressful event ke baad. So this is how you can keep उसकी problem एक तरफ रख दीजिए, इधर से इसकी problems को discuss कर दीजिए, तो automatically एक difference form में बन जाएगा. Mood disorders we will cover in the next video. Bye bye. Take care.